I'm kind of liking this 4-3, even 6-1, but I kind of like the 3-4. I don't know. I never run, but this setup, the alignment of it, I really like. I'm probably going to run 3-4 odd this year.
The Bucks offense set to begin their next possession. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Caught by Jones. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs. Run some plays. Run some clock. Allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath.
But like, you're probably going to want to run 3-4 odd just to mix it up. Like, that's what we're going to have to do in the beginning of the year.
A reminder coming up here at halftime. We'll ship you off to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman will have first half highlights and analysis from a back and forth first half that we've seen. A throw on the quick slant, going to be complete. 9 yards the pick up there, and it's
well,
a first down.
Well, that was
down.
Just, I mean,
when you're
man,
playing a quarterback with some
why.
Experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz
was
him because
it there, right there?
If he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
On first down, Brady. He's got his running back, LeSean McCoy. Now he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
It's a gain of 9. Brings up second and a yard at the 50-yard line.
Where is it at? Oh, there it is.
And just a yard to go here on second down. From midfield, here's Brady. Looking for Godwin, and he's got him complete. And he has another
right
first
there.
Down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles 39. 12 yards there and a first down.
And the Buccaneer first down.
First and 10, here's Brady. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line.
Intercepted.
That throw, Charles,
let's see if
on
I can
the middle of the field.
Perfect.
And a few too many bodies in there got picked.
All right, so
that's a normal situation, too, isn't it? No matter how hard you try and spread the field
sometimes, have to,
there's always going to be a traffic jam, it feels like, towards the middle. And if there's any type of a missed throw, or maybe the ball's tipped,
so I'm gonna
or just
keep the play
too many
up.
Bodies in the area, an interception can
one,
result.
1, 2, 3, and I'm going to go.
So after the INT, here's Wentz.
Oh, my goodness.
Looking
I got hit. Throw out a sack. That's what happens.
It's
wow.
Devin White, the linebacker. And he will score.
My first incomplete pass is a pick
Tampa
six.
Bay.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's
was
a ball
that Shaquille
like
Barrett
back,
that
and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there.
Dude,
in a hurry.
This lag is hell on us, man.
No, he missed the PAT.
Like, I almost missed
no
a freaking easy ass field goal because I was on the hash
there.
Mark.
And this will stay a 6-point
and it lagged
game.
On the way down.
The kickoff for Tampa Bay.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kicks
like,
away.
I'm honestly like thinking the best way to go is 2-4-5 odd.
And this one will not be handled. 3-4 it's into the end zone for a
odd.
Touchback.
25-yard line.
Yeah. No, because don't they have Vita Villa, Barrett, Stu? Their line's not bad. Oh yeah, I forgot they do have Pierre Paul.
The Eagles offense
not bad
set
on
to
this.
Begin their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
So that's a touchdown. Oh my goodness. So out of sack.
In this situation, if they decide to take a shot.
Yeah, it was pretty open for a one play touchdown. Especially when cover six. It bombs everything except cover three. That's good. That got really. Well, it's just the too high safety look. So that pressure that you're getting from the edge is really good.
Working from the gun, Wentz. And he finds his tight end. It's Ertz.
Yeah, it's really good.
And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. Getting it to him in space pays off big time. That winds up going for 31. 4-yard line.
2-4-5 odd. What were you running there? What formation? Yes. Yeah, because I'm thinking
so the
I'll probably
gets him across midfield now for first and 10.
All right, so here's your play art. So I'll do this for 3 seconds. 1, 2, 3. Well, I'm trying to show the play. I didn't do it the last play.
A final shot before half for Wentz.
He's open.
And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go. He was trying to find Deshaun Jackson that time. And now it's second.
You see how that I had that two routes open again?
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10.
But then a problem you're going to run into is something like this.
Sanders here as they run out of the gun.
Because inside zones
are
pretty good.
And he's going to be taken down here as that will lead us to the end of the first half of play. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
No, it was in,
all right, Coach,
remember.
Thank you.
Dude was the Ravens. And he was running like shotgun boost post and something like that.
It's the Eagles ready to see the football first. And they trail here as we resume action in this third quarter from the 6.
Now we have to do a different play so that way you can.
Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32.
I don't think I did.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 32-yard line.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. They're close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably
so
here in half two. No?
One,
I would agree
two,
with that totally.
Three.
I would guess that in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
I mean, each one has like different
variations. See if they can pick it up.
Game 10 at the 44-yard line.
Wentz now on first down. That's caught by Jackson. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. He continues to deliver a first down here. He had four catches in the first half, and this one number 5.
And the other setup right here.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Shotgun now for Wentz. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. A gain of 6 there on first.
In today's football, where receivers break tackles, make people miss, get upfield for the extra yardage, when you see a play like that where it's caught and he's dropped
this is
on the spot,
smart route, by the
that's
way,
a big-time
but it's
play
not
by the defense.
To throw again on second down. Wentz.
Yeah.
And he finds his target. It's Marquise Goodwin. And this time not quite to the 30. He'll be down at the 31-yard line. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here.
That's
and he also
much
picks up a first down.
Well, it's like 5 plays.
31
here.
Now on first and 10. Once again, Open right side, complete to Rager. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
And decided to run a hitch route. It really helped to have a guy who could turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
This is Jackson on the quick throw from
Vance.
Now a loose football. The ball comes out, and it's picked up by the Buccaneers.
He just turns it to
the end zone. A fumble recovery touchdown for the Bucs.
Tampa Bay.
This was a close game. They needed a little breathing room. Boy, they got it right there on that return for a touchdown.
I wasn't even doing any
We would say that this could be huge. It was huge. Gave him a comfortable lead.
No, I was not doing any shaking room. He just got his ass planted.
The defense more than did its job. Now the offense is summoned onto the field as they'll go for two. They're going to run for it with Jones.
Gosh.
And he will get into the end zone to extend the lead by two more.
Eagles 14.
I don't know what's wrong.
And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kicks away following that fumble return.
I mean, the run up the middle is kind of like...
And they'll watch this one fall in the end zone, and that'll be a touchback.
25-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive.
Lefty, lefty.
Oh, this isn't going to work. No, this isn't going to work.
Now, whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
This inside zone would kill it.
It'll be Sanders to begin the drive. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
And they'll work from the 29 on second and six.
And I'm surprised he's getting in because this offensive line is pretty good.
To throw, it's Wentz. Deep ball for Goodwin.
Oh my gosh, throw out a sack again.
And it's intercepted.
Dude, they get huge pressure. That was a one-play touchdown.
So
opening
drive interception to begin this second half.
And just think about the time you spend in the locker room going over what you expected to do in the second half. Not the way they saw it, not the way they drew it up. You find out this is something that you can't just edit, right? There's no rewrite here. This is live, and now they've got to find a way out of this hole.
That was wide open for a touchdown, too. No, I make sure that I make sure I three-corner him. Like, on which one? On double and sell? That's a corner. We only post on inside cross. Or,
so after the INT, it's Brady.
Oh, I messed up on the play.
He completes it to Evans. Touchdown,
Oopsie.
Tampa Bay. Mike Evans. 44 yards. And the interception by the Bucs D leads to a touchdown. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions, and I'd hear 9 from the receivers. That meant fly route, go.
A little.
Look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown. And that drives coaches insane,
doesn't
it? I just
keep getting hit
when
they
see that
ball
happen. It just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Wentz and the Eagles now with a first and 10 at the 40.
I just can't believe the pressure that Shaquille Barrett is picking up.
He's back to throw here to start the drive. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete.
But you got to think that sooner or later, they're going to hit one of those. But the coverage has been excellent thus far. And it was again on the last play.
I have like...
Second and 10 now. Third quarter action from Philadelphia, PA.
Well, I want to keep showing you the play.
Here's Wentz to throw. And down he goes. A Buccaneer sack. Shaquille Barrett put that sack by his name in the stat sheet.
Well, many times when you talk about mobile quarterbacks, you get the sense that they feel like they can get out of any bad situation. They keep moving around and trying to emulate guys like the scrambler or the dodger. Instead, they keep losing yardage and losing yardage and digging themselves a hole that they can't get out of.
Oh, he was open for a
touchdown.
It's
caught by Jackson. Oh, and he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down.
That's certainly playing down in distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
Yeah, so it's... Like, at least it's not the whole defense. At least it's whatever zones.
And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it.
I think, yeah.
Here we go on fourth down with Wentz.
What was that?
Dennis is incomplete. Boy, a real head scratcher there. And the Bucs are going to take over with excellent field position to boot. Well, at this stage of the game in the second half, down three scores.
Well, you can
I guess
see
they felt like
the
they needed
half,
to push.
And
let's face it, with this deficit,
the
if they give up another score here
kind of
after they didn't get it, does it really matter?
Right.
That
it
one
really
time
doesn't. They had to go and try and make something happen if they had any chance of winning this game.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Shotgun now for Brady. Quickly to Gronkowski. That's caught. He'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of 7.
It's a gain of nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Working with a second and 3. Working from the gun, it's Brady. He finds his target, it's Evans. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. It's a 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Yeah, how's this? It's just going to get so...
Brady now on first down. This for his running back, McCoy.
So
and he'll get it down this time to 17.
I haven't even committed.
They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
That's a good job there by the corner. And we do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
See how, like,
and now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. 7 yards on the pickup there, and now they've got it first and goal.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
From the gun, it's Brady.
Oh,
and Evans hauls it in. Touchdown, Bucs.
Mike Evans.
Mike Evans.
That was a good job.
His second touchdown of the afternoon as the Buccaneers tack
like
onto their lead.
Quicker race on him.
They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff position?
I was just worried about.
Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Yeah.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
Why can I not go?
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complimentary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7, past the 30 to the 32. He's
tackled it. But no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's second and 3. Another run with Sanders. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. Call it a gain of 3, but not enough to move the sticks. It'll be third and about a foot or two. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
On third down, they'll run it with Sanders. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. They needed a yard. They got it. First down.
First and 10 at the 36-yard line.
On first and 10, it's Sanders. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
Devin White on the tackle. 2 yards on the pickup.
It's on second down now. It's Sanders.
Yeah, I think 3-3-5 wide still works.
Over the 40 to the 42. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a third and about 4 more for a first.
And 4.
Wentz on the give to Sanders. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4.
So that's why
it's going to be better. The trend continues here in the fourth like it was in the first, second, and third. He's had nowhere to run.
And you're probably thinking to yourself, why do they keep feeding him the football? Well, they trust him first and foremost. They do believe that over time he might actually pop one of these runs. But bottom line is, he takes care of the ball well for them, so they'll keep handing it to him.
No, I'm just going to use double. Or I'm just going to use 2.
Yeah, they're indeed
going to
go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out.
It just gets gashed the inside zone too much.
The Eagles indeed snap it. Wins.
What the hell?
Be able to hook up there. It's incomplete. The Eagles unable to convert there on fourth. And the Bucs are going to take over with excellent field position to boot.
Here, punt it to me real quick.
Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts. That's going to leave them with just one remaining.
But it works well with Mahomes.
This fourth quarter.
Punt it to me real quick.
Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining.
I wonder why it works with Mahomes, but not Wentz.
And what is this? They're lining up here to punt on first down. The punt team on now
so
as
don't
Pinion
pass lead
sends
with
this
a
one
quarterback
away.
That's not.
And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose.
I guess.
But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble. That could have been trouble.
I know there's no magnet in the ball, but sometimes for the punt returner, after such a scramble, it sort of feels that way,
like
doesn't
it? Much.
He has it. He loses it. Somehow the ball finds its way back to him.
Atone for his sin, and you know he's taking a deep sigh of relief right now. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first
so
and 10.
So why did it? Why? So I don't lead him, which kind of sucks.
On first down, Wentz. Man open, it's Goodwin.
No, he automatically does that.
And they finally do get it, but not before he reaches the 27. Good. A big play there on the catch and run. 59 yards.
So
that changes things in a big way. Now from all the way down inside the 30, here's first and 10. Shotgun snap and then the give to Sanders. It'll wind up
because
being
I
a huge
try.
Loss on the play, and that's going to bring up a second.
Play that, do that one play when it's an
incomplete
pass.
I think
pass
you and I were both raised the same way in the game of football. You run to set up the pass, but I think we've discovered
pass.
In this NFL,
what is
a lot of teams
is?
Pass to set up the run, and that's what they've done throughout this game. They've aired it out, thrown it around the yard. Now they've come back to the running game, and they find a way to be successful with it.
On second and a long way to go. Wentz.
There. What
and
the
too
hell?
Much juice. It'll be out of bounds. Yeah. Incomplete.
Do that same
that the
thing.
The deep ball's been a part of their game plan all afternoon.
Like, apparently
they've had trouble hooking up on it. Unable to successfully find the end zone
like
over the
top. Those guys are open. How many guys has he missed? Let me try this again.
On third and long, it's Wentz. He'll hit Jackson complete. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A big pickup, 18 yards, but they still stop him well short of the marker.
But I know, but what? No complete four pop.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it.
I mean, it looks like you're going to have to just go for it.
They'll go for it. It's Wentz. He's going to let this go deep for Jay. It's caught at the 10. And they move this all the way down to the 9. Wow, first and goal, and defensively, all they can do is shake their heads. Not only did they allow the conversion, but a big play as well. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Get ready. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. They've got it first and goal as they look to punch in a late score.
What a play! What a play!
My goodness, it'll be a disastrous loss on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
That makes no sense. You've got to understand your situations. You're in a goal-to-go situation, and instead you're dancing around, and instead of staying at least where you were, you end up losing yards for your team.
Yeah.
A long ways to go here on second down. The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Inside the 30. A big gain there after going backwards, and that'll lead to a third down. Big play coming here. It's third and goal.
But you don't have anything that goes past 25, so it's going to be useless against.
Throwing now is Wentz. Going to throw deep for the end zone. And that is caught. Well, they're going to see this one to the end. They get a score, but pretty much an exercise in futility right now. Still down big. He took the hit when he threw that ball.
I don't think
it works. The O-line just thankful that that worked out for a touchdown.
Yeah, because, you know, their pride is don't let
that
guy
try to pass the ball.
Let's
see if I get the same block said that you
did. But anytime it pays off in a touchdown,
they'll
figure out how to block a little bit better going forward.
And his kick is right through.
Yeah, but Pearson, like,
kick it away.
There's really nothing that does anything with that.
And a short kick.
No, don't. Don't do it. No.
And it's picked up by the Eagles.
As that ball got away from him, he saw the opposing team recover it.
You felt his pain?
Oh, I felt his pain, and you know what was going through his head. Tuck it away. Take care of the ball. All the things he hears all week in practice, he didn't carry it over into the game.
And what is going on here? Are they serious? First down, and they're in punt formation.
I just said the same thing under pressure, but he
doesn't look too much
great.
Air under it. It's out of the back of the end zone. And the football will come out to the 20-yard line.
Did you 2-4-5 or do you 2-4-5 on? It's 2-4-5 is probably better.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And with the defense out of timeouts, powerless to stop the clock, this should just be a couple of kneel downs. Brady gonna throw here.
Like, it's not bad.
And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Darius Slay with a pick. And they are gonna set up shop at the 40-yard line. Well, look, we're watching a quarterback here that's obviously been around for a long time. That's a throw he wishes he had back.
He certainly does, but as you well know, this is a guy that's used to taking a few chances, used to fitting it into tight windows. These are throws that he's made before.
I mean, he's got
didn't happen to get it completed in this case.
Now on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away.
Let me try this again.
And problem spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly, so that'll come back to the 20. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They have the big cushion here in the final stages of this one. I don't know if there's any better feeling than being up big on the road.
There really can't be, because for a team to go on the road and win in the NFL, that's huge to begin with. But just think about all the preparation that went into it. When they first started talking about this game, leading up to it during the week, going on the road, unfamiliar city, obviously, unfamiliar hotel. No one's going to be with you once you get to the stadium. They're all going to be against you. You name it. All those things they had to deal with, they were able to conquer them and do it convincingly.
Yeah, they did it very convincingly, and now the final moments of this one. Brady will try again on second down. He finds McCoy.
You need edge to that back.
Getting this one up to about the 35.
Because look at how he
15 yards on the play, first down.
As a passer, you're always trying to find that open window to throw the ball downfield. How about this one? Right in the middle of the field, right in the heart of a defense.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Brady going to look to throw. It's complete. He's got
he's
the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
You just have to double team that.
He's been quiet today in the passing game, just his second catch.
Yeah, and people have to come up with schemes to limit it.
And
what a lot of teams do, they'll double him, you know, use a linebacker underneath, a safety over the top. Sometimes they'll just take a corner, maybe their third corner if he's a bigger guy, and put him on a man-to-man to try and limit his touches. Just keep mixing it up, giving different angles, different looks, like a good boxer does.
Yeah, but it's pretty
unravel.
I mean, I did like the best 4-5 with them. I just don't know if the Bucs
have anything. They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points. Continually feel like
I mean, I was efficient with Wentz, except those hits where I got the interception.
They think they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
Their defense is not very good. You just have to hope and pray that Chandler Jones gets a block shed or like Well, and then like the Bay don't have any good ones. Not bad. Well, they have Scotty Miller and they have some fast receivers, but going to be a rebel. Goodwin and Evans aren't super fast. I'm going to I'll be on later.
So,
we'll be Actually, hold on.
They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Never play by the rules, that's I'm paying my dues. They gon' try to intrude, poison the multitude. They be quick to accuse, when you got this.